Is the smallest, most maneuverable ship in your arsenal. Dual front-mounted heavy autocannons and the Blink warp drive allow corvette captains to make deadly, surgical hit-and-run strikes and wreak havoc on the enemy. Corvettes are scouts, running recon and delivering quick strikes. High speed and the warp jump ability make them perfect for hunting down pesky artillery cruisers. But corvettes may fall prey to the massive firepower of the destroyer if they aren't careful. Destroyer-class ships hit the sweet spot between the massive Dreadnought and the agile corvette. This all-around attack ship is loaded with firepower, making it the ultimate medium-range hunter. At range, destroyers should stay clear of the artillery cruiser's line of sight. A direct hit can prove devastating. In close-quarter battles, destroyers are tough enough to handle their share of fire. Their role is to dart in and cut up the support craft, like the tactical cruiser, leaving larger, more dangerous ships without defenses. Tactical cruisers play a vital support role. They can provide on-the-spot repairs, even to themselves. And when they're caught in a corner, or on the offensive, they are more than capable of causing some damage, especially against wily corvettes. As a mobile repair vessel, the tactical cruiser is the key to the survival of the fleet, and is often seen in close proximity to other friendlies. Enemy destroyers will seek to cut the tactical cruiser's lifeline. Cruiser captains should wait for a destroyer escort before moving in to support a dreadnought. Which brings us to our final ship, the Dreadnought. It's built for survivability and for causing massive damage. It's all over when one of these maneuvers alongside an enemy and delivers a broadside. The Dreadnought is the heaviest class in the fleet. They're hard to take down, and their weapons pack a brutal punch. It is foolish to take on a Dreadnought alone, and nothing is more frightening than the sight of a Dreadnought on the horizon, launching its nuclear missile. Gun for gun, the Dreadnought is strong against most ships, but poor maneuverability makes it an easy target for the long-distance sniper attacks of artillery cruisers. Before you take the helm, it is vital to understand how to handle your ship. The weapon wheel at the center of the screen acts as a targeting reticle, but also provides important information about ship energy and health. Ability hotkeys are visible at the top of the screen. Once used, they will display a countdown timer for when they can be activated again. A good captain will learn to time their attacks, switch to the secondary weapon when a primary is on cooldown. Activate your energy generator just before closing in for an attack to maximize your damage and leave your opponent in flames. Bringing the right ship to bear at the right time can mean the difference between victory and utter defeat. Remember what you've learned, and you'll be on your way to becoming one of the most renowned and feared captains in the solar system.
Looks like you went this way. Come on.
Picking up.
No need to worry just yet. And watch it. That thing could be anywhere.
I'm beginning to think we're not the hunters anymore.
Let's just clear this courtyard.
There! Come on! Through the door!
Yeah, going! Okay, you're a big fella. Easy now. Oh, that's not good.
Some help here!
knew a young woman who would defy anyone and anything in order to do what she felt was right. But you're clearly not her. You're broken.
Anything having to do with Gabriel Kruger, we need to stay miles away from.
Look, I thought that this would be a good...
No, you didn't think, Faith. You never do.
Don't get lost.
Barely out of prison and already stirring things up? Your parents would be proud.
Mr. Kruger, he is out for runner blood. Whatever it is you stole from him must be very valuable.
Stop her! If you keep this up, I swear you'll be dead in a month.
Using every weapon at our disposal, we've got to destroy it.
Back off!
Kruger did this.
And he'll be able to do it to anyone unless he stopped.
Get out of my sight!
That's it?
What else is there?
You're wrong. I'm not broken.
Prove it.
A fighter in you after all.
はい、バトルはこうシームレスにこのようにつながってすぐバトルになります。丸ボタンが、通常攻撃になります。
今やってるのが通常ですね。
はい、丸ボタンの通常攻撃ですか、小攻撃ですか。これはですね、出が早い攻撃になります。あ、もう倒しちゃった方が早いか、これ。
じゃあ丸攻撃
だけで倒しちゃいましょうか、はい、ちなみにあの仲間は AI で今動いております。
はい
はい、
じゃあ続いてこのまま上に登っていって、
は
い、
そうですね、
また同じ敵ですね。
はい、はい、じゃあ続いて大攻撃を説明します。はい、大攻撃は、バスボタンです。このようにですね、攻撃するキャラクターが青いオーラに包まれます。大攻撃は出が遅いんですけれども攻撃力が強いです。はい、その代わり小攻撃に、スピードで打ち負けてしまうという攻撃になります。
はい、
はい、なんで基本的にはこの大攻撃小攻撃をうまく使い分けて戦っていただくこと
です。まあ、コンボするとコンボボーナスですね。
そうですね。はい、これスターオーシャン3のディレクターズカットあたりかな入ってるんですけれども、攻撃モーション中にですね、他の攻撃の、ボタンを押しますとこのようにキャンセルボーナスというのがつきます。
はい、
はい、キャンセルボーナスは4段階ありまして、攻撃力が 100% から 125%、150%、175%、200% というところで最大 200% の攻撃力になるというようになります。
はい、じゃあ続いて
ちょっとガードいってみましょうかね。
こいつの攻撃ガード、
はい、はい、次、四角ボタンで、ガードになります。ガードはですね、一応こう向いてるキャラクターの向いてる方向だけなくガードをしていると全方向ガードにはなります。ダメージ軽減するだけではなく、小攻撃といったような、出の早い攻撃をですねこれで潰すことができます。でさらにこのガードが成功したときにもう1回ガードボタンを押すとですね、あれうまくいかないな、なかなか殴ってくれない。
ああ、ビクトルさん。
ビクトルさん倒しちゃったな。
頑張っちゃいます。
はい。あ、ちなみに
ロールのレベルは
今ロールのレベルが上がりましたね。これロールに関しては経験値別個ありまして、これをですねつけて戦っているとロールのレベル。
So this is a giant sandbox that we're making, a universe-sized sandbox. It's full of choices.Like here, we're at the boundary between two warring factions. I could join in, I could take sides. Cool. So that's it.So here we are in an undiscovered solar system. Probably no one's ever been here before. I can do a scan. And when I do, you'll see some points of interest. That red one down there is a beacon. And I've made it so that there's always a beacon near where I warp in just for this. So beacons are where you... Beacons are where you upload discoveries. That's it over there, behind that rock. And this is the planet that we've just found. This is an alien world that we found together. This is planet E3. And it's not like the prettiest planet I've seen better, but I've also seen a lot worse. So I could do a scan, and as luck would have it, there's no alien life, but I could show you this. So every planet in every solar system...
Harder than I thought. Okay, those canisters should be full by now. Just a couple more. Oh, come on! Yes! Thank you.
floating device, perfect for taking out combatants hiding in cover. In the previous Deus Ex, Human Revolution, we knew that our combat pillar wasn't quite on par with the stealth one. This time around, we put a lot of effort and energy into making the combat pillar as visceral, rich, and a fun of an option to play as the stealth one. Adam's arsenal, the Titan Shield. This allows Adam to become for a short instant a human tank and face heavy fire. We have much more possibilities now with weapon customization on the fly. You can change your ammo type or even upgrade your weapon to fit with your playstyle. Here we've used an EMP frag grenade to disable the turret and armor-piercing bullets to destroy it.
No, I won't be afraid.